नियतिकृतनियमरहितां ख्लादेकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. पददोष वाक्यदोष एण्ड् पदांशदोषाः. नौ वी हेव् टु लुक् एट् वाक्यमात्रदोषाः विच् आर् 21 इन् नम्बर्. द डिफ्रेन्स् बिट्वीन् वाक्यमात्रदोषाः एण्ड् वाक्यदोषाः आर् पददोषाः पदांशदोषाः आर् See, the list of doshas that he gave for pada doshas can be treated as vakya dosha. There are some of which can be treated as vakya dosha. So out of the 16 pada doshas that were mentioned, 13 could occur both in padam and vakyam. 7 of those he highlighted to say that it can be in padam, vakyam and padamsha. Or some of those can be only in padam and padamsha. It cannot exist in vakya. So those that pada doshas, the number he mentioned is like one superset where he just took 13 of them and showed vakya doshaha and padamsha doshaha. Now this vakya matra doshaha are a set of doshas which are completely new and exist only in vakyam. They neither exist in padam nor do they exist in padamsha. पदांशे अपि न विद्यन्ते, पदे अपि न विद्यन्ते, वाक्यमात्रम् इत्युक्ते वाक्ये एव विद्यन्ते इत्यतः वाक्यमात्रदोषाः. लुप्तविसर्गम् इन् देर् यु हेव् टु आफ् दोस्. सो प्रतिकूलवर्णम् इस् फस्ट् वन्. उपहतविसर्गत्वं, लुप्तविसर्गत्वं, विसन्धि, हतवृत्तं, न्यून अधिक कथित पदम्. दीस् आर् अगेन् स्प्लिट् इन् टु त्री सेयिङ्ग् न्यूनपदत्वम्, अधिकपदत्वं, कथितपदत्वं. सो त्री आर् सेड् इन् वन् समास देर्. द नेक्स्ट् इस् पतत् प्रकर्षं, समाप्त पुनरात्तं. द नेक्स्ट् वन् अर्धान्तरैकवाचकम् अभवन्मतयोगम्. And then anabihita vachyam, apadastha padasamasam, sankirnam, garbitam, prasiddhi, hatam, bhagna prakramam, akramam, amata parartham cha, vakyameva tatha. Vakyameva ityukte vakyamatre eva vidyante natu pade natu padamshi. So the 21 as such are pratikula varnatvam, upahata visargatvam, lupta visargatvam, visandhi, hatavrittam, nyunapadatvam, adhikapadatvam, kathitapadatvam, patat prakarsham, samapta punarattam, ardhantaraika vachakam, abhavanmatayogyatvam, anabihita vachyatvam. In that asthanastha padatvam and asthana samasam, the text gives as apadastha pada samasam. Apadastha padam, apadastha samasam. You split it into two like that. So apadastha padam, where asthane yaha padaha or asthane padam vidyate, asthane samasam. So apadastha samasam, sankirnam, garbitam, prasiddhihatam, bhagna prakramam, akramam and amata parartham. Let's look at the first one, which is pratikula varnatvam. Now this pratikula varnatvam, the definition he gives is rasa anugunatvam varnanam vakshyate tad viparitam pratikula varnam. Rasa anugunatvam varnanam vakshyate. Now until this it should be understood as vakshyate means he is going to say it in the eighth ullasa when he is talking about the gunas, madhuryam etc., kavya gunas. He is going to talk about that in the Ashtama Ullasa. Vakshyate, Ashtama Ullase Vakshyate, yat rasa anugunanam varnanam. So each rasa has certain letters which are anuguna, which are appropriate to the to bringing out the rasa in a beautiful manner. So there he is going to say about what is the anuguna varnaha. Atra pratikula varnaha uchyante. If there are varnas that are used which are pratikula, which are not appropriate for that rasam, then it is a vakyamatra dosha called pratikula varnatva. Etha shringare, shringara rase, akunthot kanthaya purnam, akantham kalakanthimam, kambukanthyaha kshanam kanthe, kuru kanthartim uddhara. The moment you hear so many kantha, without knowing the meaning, you will first think that someone is trying to behead someone. That's the meaning that will come out in our mind, or the impression that comes out. He is actually talking about a Nayaka is waiting to be with the Nayika, and he is calling the Nayika and asking her to embrace him. That's the import of the shloka. But because of the usage of the letter ta in excess, this vakya is not shringara rasa anugunatvam na vartate asmin padye. So let's look at the meaning. Hey kalakanthi, kalakanthi, kala is beautiful, madhura, sweet voiced, one who has a very sweet voice. Mam purnam akantham akuntha utkanthaya kshanam kambukantyaha kante kuru. Kantarthim Uddhara. He's asking her to come and embrace her. Alinganam Kuru iti vadati saha. Katham apurnam maam kante kuru. Maam kambukantyaha kante kuru. Why don't you embrace me? Kante kuru. That is, place me at your neck. That is the literal meaning there. It means alinganam kuru. Tava kante maam kuru. So tava, instead of saying tava, he says kambu kantyaha. You already have a kantha, a neck which is like a kambu. Kambu griva, and the conch, like how shankha is there. Shankha iva sundaraha kanthaha yasyaha sa. So kambu kantyaha tava kante maam kuru. Alinganam kuru. And so kanta artim uddhara. Kanta arti. Arti is kashtam. Remove the pain that is there, or the pain of eagerness, of the longing. Remove that pain from me. So kanta artim uddhara. Remove that from me. Akunta utkantaya purnam akantam kante kuru. How should you embrace me now? Akunta utkantaya. I'm filled with purnam akantham. I'm filled with the utkantaya purnam maam. It is an adjective for maam. So utkantaya purnam maam. I'm filled with longing, and that longing is akuntha apratihata. It is an uninhibited longing that I have for you. Tadrisham maam purnataya kante kuru. That's the meaning of the shlokam. Not a very great shloka. At the same time, the words, the letters ta, are not very conducive to giving rise to Shringara Rasam also. Raudre yatha. So next he takes up the example of Raudra Rasam. These ta letters are actually a guna for Raudra Rasam, whereas it is not a gunam, it is not anukulam for Shringara Rasam. In Raudram, the same way, if you do not use Parushakshara, then it is not a gunam. It is actually pratikula varnam. Rasa anugunam nasti. Rasa pratikula varnaha mridu varnaha. Raudra rase mridu varnaha pratikula varnaha. Shringara rase tu parushaksharani pratikula varnani bhavanti. So deshaha soyam arati shonita jalaihi yasmin hradaf puritaha kshatradeva tathavidav paribhavaha tatasya keshagrahaha tanyeva ahita heti ghasmara guruni astrani bhasvanti me yad rameda kritam tadeva kurute dronatmajaha krodhanaha. This is a shloka from Beni Samharam, where in the Tritiyanka, Ashwathama is so angry and he is talking to Karna. He says, I'm going to kill Drona Atmajaha. Drona Atmajaha, I am Drona's son. I am going to do the same thing that Parashurama did in that point. When the Parashurama avatara had happened, what did he do? So I am Deshaha. This place was completely, the tataka, hradaha puritaha, the lakes were filled. This place is where the lakes have been filled with the raktam, rudhiram, the blood of the kshatriyas by Parashurama. Arati shonita jalaihi yasmin hradaha puritaha soyam deshaha. This place that we are standing in, or this Bharata Desham, is the place where the Hradaha Puritaha, Hradaha Tadakaha, lakes have been completely filled with what? Arati Shonita Jalaihi. Arati Shonitam Shatru Rudhiram Tadeva Jalam. Tadrasha Jalaihi Puritaha Hradaha Asmin Deshe. Next is Kshatradeva Tathavidaha Paribhavaha Tatasya Keshagraha. Parashurama had killed all the Kshatriyas and filled the lakes here with their blood, and the same Kshatriya has now insulted my father by pulling his hair. So Drupada's son Drishtadyumna caught hold of Drona's hair and cut his head, right, beheaded him. So Kshatradeva, Kshatriyat eva, ayam paribhavaha tatasya, mama pituhu ayam paribhavaha, koyam paribhavaha tathavidaha paribhavaha keshagraha asit, Kshatriyadeva asit. Tanyeva ahita heti ghasmara guruni astrani me bhaswanti, me astrani. Now tanyeva, Parashurama's, so you can also say that this Kshatriya, not only Drishtadyumna, Parashuramasya tatasyapi evameva paribhavaha abhut. Kartavirya Arjuna, he killed Parashurama's father. So paribhavaha Kshatradeva, Kartavirya Arjuna rupa Kshatriyadeva, Parashuramasya tatasyapi keshagraha nama paribhavaha abhut. So he is comparing his actions with Parashurama. So both actions are going to go for both Parashurama and Ashwathama. So the first he says, this place, it can either be the Kurukshetram or Jamadagni Ashram, or the entire bhumi where Parashurama had killed a lot of Kshatriyas and filled the lakes, formed lakes with their blood. So that is Parashurama. Here in Kurukshetra also there have been so many Shatruvadha, so much of Shatruvadha that their blood have formed lakes here. So that goes for both Ashwathama and Parashurama. Kshatradeva tatha vidha paribhavaha tatasya keshagraha. Drishtadyumna caught Drona's hair and beheaded him. The same way Kartavirya Arjuna also beheaded Jamadagni. Keshagraham akarot. The same way. Next is Tanyeva ahita heti ghasmara guruni astrani bhaswanti me. Tanyeva me api astrani tanyeva bhanti. Just like how Parashurama's astras, Brahmastra, etc. were bhanti, they bhaswanti, they were shining forth in a very beautiful manner. In the same way, mama api astrani bhaswanti bhavanti. Bhaswanti astrani, how are the astras? Ahita heti ghasmara guruni. Ahita heti ghasmara, heti is wound. They are capable of wounding the shatru. Ahita shatrunam, ahita, sorry, not ahita. Tanyeva ahita ahitanam. I kept mentioning ahita here, sorry. Ahita, yaha ahitaha saha mitram, yaha ahitaha saha shatruhu. So ahitanam, shatrunam, heti, hetayaha shastrani, Tesham ghasmara guruni tana nashitum shaknoti mama astrani. So my weapons are capable of ghasmara. They are so heavy, or they are great. Guruni, they are great because they can ghasmara, they can destroy the enemy's heti shastra weapons. Ahita heti, the shatru's weapons are being destroyed by my astra, and Parashurama's also was capable of that. So yatu Ramena kritam, yatu Parashurameena kritam purvam, tadeva krodhana ayam dronatmachaha kurute, tadeva ayam krodhana dronatmachaha Ashwathama api, yatu Parashurameena kritam, tadeva ayam Ashwathama api karoti. So he compares both Parashurama's and his own actions and says this shloka. Now let's just read this shloka once more. Deshasoyam arati shonita jalair yasmin hradav puritaha. The words are not at all Parushaksharam. Even though there is a long samasa there, arati shonita jalaihi. Even if there is a long samasa, ahita heti ghasmara guruni astrani bhaswanti me. Even if it is got a long samasa, it still does not carry the weight of the Raudra rasam that we need here. It's not Veera rasam. If the meaning conveyed is Veera rasa, then it is okay, because you have a mixture of both Parushaksharam and Sukumaraksharam. Then it is okay. You can probably accept it. But the meaning that comes out, and when he says Krodhanaha Dronatmajaha Yad Ramena Kritam Parashuramena Yadrisham Yadrisham Karma Kritam Tadrisham Eva Mayapi Kriyate Adhuna. So that sort of an anger that he is trying to display does not have a place in our mind because of the letters that he uses here. Kshatra Deva Tata Vidav Paribhavaha Tatasya Keshagraha. The letters he uses are very Sukumara Aksharam. Hence, it is Pratikula Varnatva. The Varnas, that the letters that have to be used for Raudra Rasa Anukula Varnaha Atrana Yujyante Atrana Prayujyante Iti Karanat Atra Pratikula Varnatva Iti Dosha. Vakyamatra Dosha. Now, atrachhi, the explanation he gives for this is atrahi vikata varnatvam dirgha samasatvam cha uchitam tanna vidyate. So, vikata varnatvam ityukte parusha varnatvam uchitam dirgha samasatvam cha uchitam tadeva raudra rasasya anugunatvam. Now, how is it in, he is now giving a counter example. Now, showing where vikata varnatvam api asti, दीर्घ समासत्वम् अपि अस्ति तस्मात् रौद्ररस अनुगुणत्वं तत्र वर्तते इति प्रत्युदाहरणं दर्शयति अत्र यथा प्राग् अप्राप्त निशुम्भ शाम्भव धनुः द्वेधा विधाव आविर् द्वे धनुर्द्वेधा द्वेधा विध आविर्भवत् द्वेधा विध आविर्भवत् क्रोध प्रेरित भीम भार्गव भुज स्तंभाप विद्ध क्षणात्. Very difficult to even pronounce because you need more of breath to say those Parushaksharam and the Mahapranaksharam. Ujjvala Parashur Bhavat Ashitilaha Tvatkantha Peethatitihi Yenanena Jagat Sukhanda Parashuhu Devo Harah Khyapyate. By looking at the shloka, you will know that the first three lines are very, very ujjwala aksharam. It shines forth with a lot of parushakshara and long samasa. The entire first and second, almost until the end of the second pada, it is one samasta pada. From pragaprapta until apaviddhaha, kshanate is the only word that is separate. Until that, it is just one single word. That is the Dirgha Samasatvam that is expected in Raudra Rasam. Here, it is a description of Parashurama. This occurs in Mahavira Charitam written by Bhagavati. So, this scene is Rama has broken the Shivadhanus. So it is an insult to Shiva. How can anybody break Shiva Dhanus? They will have to, encounter me. I am Shiva's Shishya. And if they have broken my Guru's bow, it is an insult to my Guru. So let him, I will have to immediately kill him. So he says, Mama Parashuhu, Tava Kanta Atitihi Bhavatu. Let my Parashu, my axe, be an Atiti, be a guest to your neck. Kanta Atitihi, Kanta Pita Atitihi Bhavatu, Mama Parashuhu. So let my axe, Parashu, be a guest to your neck, which means let me behead you. Ashitilaha Tvat Kanta Pita Atitihi. So Ashitilaha Parashuhu, Ujjwalaha Ashitilaha Cha Mama Parashuhu. My Parashu is actually Kshanat, within a moment, Tvat Kantha Rupe Peethe Asane Atitihi Bhavatu. Tvat Kantha Peetha Atitihi Bhavatu. How is that Parashu? Everything else is an adjective to that Parashu. There are three adjectives, which is Ashithilaha. It is not a very soft weapon. It is an extremely harsh, very strong weapon, Parashuhu. And Ujjwalaha, it is also shining forth. immediately it is ujjvalaha asti, or it is sending forth udgata jwala yasmat tadrishaha ujjvalaha parashuhu. No, when you strike metal against strike, there are sparks that come out of that metal weapons. So that is so jwala yuktaha ayam parashuhu iti vadati. And the next one is the big samasa, dirgha samasa that we have to break down. Apaviddha. So this parashu is apaviddha. It is being moved by apaviddha itukte chalitaha. So chalitaha ayam parashu. It is constant. It's adavadhu Tamil la vandhu we say tudikkirathu avade vetrathukku. It is just waiting to hit someone. So tadrishaha, which is kampana yuktaha asti, chalana yuktaha asti, ayam parashuhu, apaviddaha. Kena apaviddaha, bhujastambena apaviddaha. My hand is holding this apaviddha. How is my hand? Bhargava bhujastambaha. Parashurama is holding this parashu, who is actually krodha prerita bhima bhargavaha. He is very fearsome to look at, because it has been prompted by the anger that is there in him. That Bhargava is fearsome because of the anger that is present in him. And that anger has come about. Why has that anger risen? It is because someone has broken the Shivadhanus into two. So Prag Aprapta, the Shivadhanus which had not gotten broken before. Prak apraptam nishumbham. Nishumbha ityukte khandanam. So prag apraptam khandanam yasya shambhava dhanushaha. So the shambhava dhanuhu, Shiva dhanus, which had not hitherto been broken, prag aprapta nishumbha Shiva nishumbham Shiva dhanuhu, tasya dvedha vidha khanda dvaye adhuna ramena kritam. So he has now broken it into two, and dvedha vidha avirbhavat. Because of that breaking into two, now there is an anger within me because of that, and that anger has prompted me to become bhima bhargava, not a sadharana bhargavaha, bhima bhargavaha, fearsome, bhayankaraha bhargavaha. Tasya bhar tadrisha bhargavasya bhujastambena apaviddaha chalitaha parashuhu ayam. Now the moment you hear that, you can pictureize Parashurama in front of you. He is so angry that the Shivadhanus has been broken. Because of that, he is looking like looking very bhayankaraha, and he is shaking his parashu in his hand. And because of that friction, there is a jwala that is coming out of that parashu. Ashitilaha api. Just because it is shaking, don't think that it is going to fall off from my hand. It is not going to fall off. Ashitilaha. It's a very strong weapon that I hold in my hand. And Tvadkanta Pita Titihi Bhavatu, let it fall on your neck. Then, why so much of anger arises? He shows in the fourth line his reverence towards Shiva. He says, Yena Anena Parashuna Jagatsu Khanda Parashuhu Devaha Haraha Khyapyate. Haraha devaha khanda parashuhu iti khyapyate iti jnayate sarvaihi jagatsu. In the world, Shiva is called khanda parashu because of this parashu. There is a Purana katha there. During Dakshayagna, Shiva wanted to destroy that yagna because Sati yoga visrishta deha. She gives up her body through yoga, and Shiva gets very angry and upset with this, and so he first sends forth many people there to fight and destroy the Rakshayajna. Nara and Narayana are trying to protect the yajna. Just that some good thing should not be destroyed like this by Shiva. And why should Shiva get such a bad name? So they are trying to protect it, and Narayana sends forth an arrow to stop Shiva, and Shiva, that arrow changes into parashu. That parashu, Shiva immediately breaks it into two. khanda parashuhu. When after he breaks it into two, one of that khandam, he gives it to Parashurama, who is his shishya. When Parashurama comes and learns all the astram and everything, astra vidya from Shiva, Parashurama receives this part of that Parashu, and that is the Parashu that Parashurama holds, Bhargavarama. Okay, so yena anena parashuna jagatsu jagati khanda parashu. Jagatsu means swarge patale bhumam api trijagatsu. So in all the three worlds, Shiva haraha devaha khanda parashuhu iti khyapyate. So that's why you will find even in Vishnu Sahasranama khanda parashu daruno dravina pradaha. Even in Vishnu Sahasranama, Narayana is called khanda parashu because yena parashuhu or yasya parashuhu khanditaha. So khandaha parashuhu yasya saha. Here for Shiva, you will take that samasa as khandaha parashuhu yena saha. Who caused that parashu to be broken? Whereas here, whose parashu was broken? For Narayana. So there he has not used Dirgha Samasam, nor has he used Vikata Varnatva. Whereas in the first three padas, there is. So this is actually an example of the correct manner, the right manner in which the letters have to be used for that particular rasa. So yatratu na krodaha, where there is no krodha, the fourth line, tatra is equal to chaturthapada abhidane. So chaturthapade. Tatra, tatra means chaturtha pada abhidane. While saying that fourth padam, he tathaiva shabda prayogaha, tathaiva ityukte sukumara varnatva seva, shithilaha eva varnaha upayuktaha. So shithila shabda prayogaha, tatra upayuktaha chaturtha pade. Why? Because there is no krodham there. Only in the first three where he is saying, I'm going to kill you. He is talking to Rama. That is where he uses Parushaksharam and Dirgha Samasattvam. So this is also a Vakya Matra Dosham. Now let us go to the next two, second and third, which is Upahata Lupta Visargatvam, which is Upahata Visargatvam and Lupta Visargatvam. He gives only one shloka for that, where the first line is Upahata Visargatvam and the second line is Lupta Visargatvam. धीरो विनीतो निपुणो वराकारो नृपो अत्र सह यस्य भृत्या बलोत्सिक्ता भक्ता बुद्धि प्रभाविता. नाउ दीस टू एंड द नेक्स्ट वन विसंधि ऑल आर बेस्ड ऑन पाणिनीज रूल्स. सो धीरो विनीतो निपुणो वराकारो वर आकारः नृपः. एवरीथिंग इज अ विसर्ग एंडिंग वर्ड. धीरः एकः, दिस इज अ डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ राजा. सः नृपः. Dhiraha is a brave person, or dhiraha ityukte panditaha ityapi vaktum shakyate. Sthitadhir muni ruchyate. So panditaha is also fine. Vinitaha, shastra, he follows, he is very disciplined because of following the shastras. Nipunaha, expert. Vara akaraha, sreshta akaraha yasya saha. Varaha, varakaraha. So he has a very beautiful form. Saundaryaha, sundaraha saha nrapaha. Yasya Brityaha, whose servants, Bala Utsiktaha, they are also very Utsiktaha, Garvitaha. Yasya Balena, Drupasya, Yasya Drupasya Balena, Tasya Sevakaha, Abhi Utsiktaha, Garva Purnaha Bhavanti. Or you can say that even his Britya, his Sevaka, are very strong. And or you can say Britya, instead of Sevaka, you can take it as Bhataha or warriors who are very proud about their strength. Bhaktaha, they are loyal to the king. And Buddhi Prabhavitaha. Tasya Buddhya Prabhavitaha, they are influenced by the king's Buddhi. Or you can also say it as Brityaha Swabuddhya Api Prabhavitaha. They themselves are intelligent. They are strong and they are extremely loyal to the king, who is dhiraha vinitaha nipunaha varakaraha. Shloka is fine. The problem here is upahata visargatvam and lupta visargatvam. It does not It is everything is in accordance to the Vyakarana rules that he says. Now let's look at the Vyakarana rule. Upahata visargatvam. Upahatam upahatatvam nama utpa praptihi. Utvam tu atoror apluta taplute hashicha ityanena dhiraha vinitaha. You have that word. And then vinitaha nipunaha. So dhiraha plus vinitaha. Hashicha, hash are the letters where you have hayavarat, hayavara, lan. It goes till jabanjagadash, jabagadash. Until those, you have those letters. Any of those letters, if it comes after the upasarga, then that upasarga gets the utvam. And then, why am I saying upasarga? Sorry, visarga. The visarga has a sa and that sakara becomes u. Then you have dhira plus u plus vinitaha. That becomes dhiro vinitaha. That takes adgunaha and then you get dhiro vinitaha. The same way here also, vinitaha plus nipunaha. Vinitaha nipunaha. Vinitaha. There you have a hraswa akara ataha. Roho aplutat aplute. So there is a ru there which gets an u. Too many rules involved. So the end result is actually the visarga becomes o. Visarga becomes u, and that u joins with the akara that is there at the end of the padam, which is dhira plus u or vinita plus u. And then nipuna, and then the same way nipuna u, and then varakaraha, the same way varakara u nripaha. That is how the samasa is, and then the dhira plus u will join together to give a guna letter, which is dhiro. Then vinito nipuno. It's a proper sandhi rules are applied, and the words have been formed according to the grammar rules. There is no issue there. Okay, utva praptihi atra vidyate. Utva praptihi kasya visargasya utva praptihi because of these two sutras. Okay, now what is the problem? Dhiro vinito nipuno varakaro nrupotra saha. This entire way of saying it does not have a tightness in the shlokam. That bandha or the shlokas formation has a shaithilyam. Shithilata means it is not tight. It is a very loose construct. There is no tightness. Maybe dhiro vinito matiman, then there would be a tightness there. You understand? See, dhiro vinito nipuno, it is again, it does not get dhiro vinito. Matiman might be actually a good one here. Then it gets a stop there, and there is a tightness to that construct, and it's like it is locking it in the way you are saying. So the rhythm of the shloka is such that it is too loose. Varakaro nripotra saha. I think actually that matiman would have been better. Dhiro vinito matiman varakaro nripotra saha. Would have been perfect, then there would be no dosha in that shloka. The next one, yasya brithya balotsikta bhakta buddhi prabhavita. Everywhere brithyaha balotsiktaha bhaktaha, all three visarga have been elided here. That is their lopa adrishtaha atra because of these sutra. Here you have sasajushoruhu is one sutram where brityaha, actually the visargam is brityas, is there. That is has been made into ruhu. And then bho bhago ago apurvasya, you have ya, and then ya is lopam. So the rules that apply are these three again. So you have, instead of brityaha balotsiktaha, you have brithya balotsikta. Balotsiktaha bhaktaha, instead of that you have balotsikta bhakta. Everywhere it is a lupta visargatvam. Again, that bandha shaitilyam is there. Maybe something else can... I'm just trying to coin a word. So, yasya brithya balotsikta bhakta buddhi prabhavitaha. Instead of bhakta, if there is some word where balotsiktas तत्रैते बुद्धिप्रभाविताः समथिङ्ग् लैक् दट् केन् इट् वुड् हव् मेड् द बन्धं मोर् टैट् दिस् इस् अ नित्यदोषं because it is immediately there is no concept of that shloka or that meaning or anything. You only feel that you are not able to recite the shloka very nicely, and hence it is a nitya dosha. So two are mentioned here, where upahata uttvam praptaha luptaha va visargaha yatra tat yatha viro vinito nipuno. Next one is visandhi. Visandhi, the meaning of visandhi is sandhehe vairupyam, and there are three varieties of sandhehe vairupyam. Vairupyam sandhi actually means samhita. Samhita is where if there is a possibility of two, when two letters are present near each other, there is a possibility of both combining, and that combination is called sandhi in grammar. Or it is also samhita, means the presence of those two together. When those two are present together, I can't say one word today and say a word tomorrow, and both those two words have to be sandhi. No, you have to say it immediately together near each other, and then there is a possibility of sandhi. So where are all the areas? Panini and the Bhartikara and all give us rules for where sandhi have to be applied and where it is not applied. So sandhehe vairupyam is of three types. Vairupyam is just something which is not, let's say it is vi sandhi is sandhehe vairupyam. So it is not something which is good or which is not how it should be. So there are three types, which is vishleshaha, ashleelattvam and kashtatvam cha. So vishleshaha is sandhyabhavaha. Ashleelattvam is where you have done the sandhi according to the rules, but the words that come out of that sandhi give us a very jugupsa yukta, vrida yuktam or jugupsa yuktam meaning for us. The third type is kashtatvam, where it is difficult to pronounce. Shruti katutvam comes there because of the sandhi, and that sandhi present is present only in vakyam. So tatra adyam, let's look at this. So visandhi is sandehe vairupyam, and the first one is vishlesha rupaha. The next two shlokas are for vishlesha rupa. Vishleshaha means sandhi abhavaha. Sandhi abhava can happen in three ways. One is aichikaha, another is pragrihya hetukaha, another is asiddhi hetukaha. So one, it's actually two types, aichikaha and anushasanika. Follows and there is a sandhi abhava, there is no sandhi, that is anushasanikaha. And that anushasanika can occur in two ways. One is prakrihyam or prakriti bhava sandhi. The other is asiddhi, where one rule has been applied and then another rule becomes defunct and it cannot be applied. That is your asiddhi hetukam. Each one we are going to look at it in detail. The first type is aichikaha. For that, aichika means icha rupam. It is according to the wish of the vakta, vivaksha. Now there are two rules for sandhi. Praptasya sandehe eva abhavaha. There should occur a sandhi. There, in certain places there is nitya sandhi, and in certain places there is anitya sandhi or vivaksha hetukam. So two explanations are given. One is sandhir ekapade nityo, nityo dhatu pasargayoho, sutreshu cha bhavet nityaha, saiva anyatra vibhashaya. Excuse me, 1 minute. So sandhi can occur in ekapadam, in one padam itself, where the pada has not been completely formed and I still have Rama as the pratipadikam, and then Su is there. I am using a pratyayam. Prakriti and pratyayam are present. It has still not been formed into a padam completely. In that ekapade tu sandhihi nityaha eva. It has to be formed. I cannot always keep on saying instead of Ramaha gachati, I can't say Rama su gachati. That doesn't exist at all. यू के नॉट हैव इट लाइक दैट. सो संधि इज नित्यम देयर. धातु उपसर्गयो हो तो आई के नॉट से अनु गच्छति. Gachati Anu has a different meaning than Anugachati. If you study Vibhakti Artha Prakaranam, you will know the difference. Anu, Prati, all these have to be formed. Prati Agachati. So Prati Agachati is different from Pratyagachati. Pratyagachati, he goes towards it, or Pratyagachat. So Dhatu Upasargayoho Madhye Nityaha Sandhihi Bhavitavya. Next, sutreshu cha bhavet nityam. Wherever you have a sutra, in the sutra literature, all the sandhi have to be done. It should not be separate. If I say, for example, idu de dvivachanam pragrihyam, I can't say eet, oot, eet, dvivachanam pragrihyam. I should not be saying the sutra in that manner. It should be eetu de dvivachanam pragrihyam. That's how the sutra has to be pronounced. Anyatra vibhashaya saeva sandhi saiva sandhihi. That sandhi can be vibhasha. Vibhasha is optional everywhere else. You want, you can make a sandhi. Otherwise, you don't need to. In the same manner, another shloka also describes where sandhi is nityam and where it is not. Samhitaikapadeya nitya. This is the most popular shloka. The other one is not as popular. Samhitaikapade nitya nitya dhatu upasargayoho nitya samase vakyetu sa vivaksham apekshate. Samhita ekapade samhita nitya. Samhita ityukte sandhihi. Sandhihi karya. Ekapade nitya karya. Nityam karya. It should definitely be done. Dhatu upasargayoho api sa nitya. Samase nitya. I cannot have, we use hyphen within a samasa for that. That's why we don't write it as separate words. Hyphen is a modern way of representing that. It is a samasta padam, and it is one padam. At the same time, there are individual words that are present in that one padam. So it's using modern technology for olden days. That's all. If you look at old Sanskrit manuscripts, it will just be one word. You won't know where the sandhi is, you won't know how the words are going to be split. That is why Vyakhyana is present. There are so many commentaries. So, samhita ekapade nitya nitya dhatu upasargayoho nitya samase vakye tu sa vivaksham apekshate. Vakye, in a sentence, vivaksham apekshate. Now, there is no mention of padyam or shloka. So, what people do is, in order to facilitate the meter for meter problems, sometimes they separate it saying vakye aichikam padyam api vakyam iti vadanti. It's correct, there is no issue, but it is aichika, it does not gel with the way we say it. The first example that he gives is rajan vibhati bhavatas charitani tani इंदोर द्युतिम दधति यानि रसातलयन्तः धीर दो धीदोर बले अति तते उचितानुवृत्ति आतन्वति विजय संपदम एत्य भातः. The shloka, let me get the meaning out of the way and then go to the sandhi part. हे राजन् भवतः चरितानि विभाति विभान्ति, should be विभान्ति ल विभान्ति. ऐ मेड् अ मिस्टेक् हियर्, सारि. राजन् हे राजन् तव भवतः चरितानि, योर् ग्रेट् स्टोरीस्, ग्रेट् द एक्शन्स् विभान्ति, दे आर् शैनिङ्ग् फोर्त् लैक् द इन्दु. इन्दोः द्युतिं ददति. They are having the charitam has the prakasham duty of indoho kanti. Indoho kantim dadati yasya charitani. So it means that it is very white, and in other words, it is very famous. So yashaha in kavi samayam is white, hence it is compared to the prakasham of chandra. So the moon's it is like it is shining forth like the prakasha, having the prakasham of Chandra. Your stories, the bhavataha charitani, tani charitani, those prasiddha charitam that you have done, all those prasiddha actions which are indoho dyutim dadati, which have the Chandra prakasha, rasatale antaha vibhanti, they are shining even in the rasatale antaha. Even in the rasatalam, that is patala lokam, patala a patalam prakashanti. So your stories and fame is shining forth even in the patala. Your dhi and dorbala, that is one sentence. The other sentence is not only your charitam, your dhihi, intellect, and dorbala, the strength of your shoulders, your arm strength, both of those, it is in dual. The second line, if you look, the next four words are all in dual. Dvivachane. Napunsakalingam dvivachanam. So, dheer, dheedor bale, your intellect and strength, atitate, it is being very widespread, ativistrute, uchita anuvritti, uchita anuvritti, atanvati, atanvati, has an uchita anuvritti, it functions in the right manner. Uchita prakarena atanvati or uchita karmam karma vidyate asmin. So they are able to function in the right manner. Uchita anuvritti atanvati dhidorbale vijaya sampadam yetya bhataha. Vijaya sampadam, they bring forth vijaya and sampad. Because of the dhihi, you have a vijaya. Both of those work together and bring about victory and sampat or chelvam, another wealth. So they bring forth wealth and sampat, wealth and victory and shine. Bhataha. Now let's look at the grammar part here. So aichikaha sandhyabhavaha. Prakrihya hetukaha anushasanikaha, asiddhi hetukaha anushasanikaha, all three are being covered in these two shlokas. So the first two are covered in the first shloka. That is aichikaha sandhyabhavaha. Here tani indoho dyutim actually have to come together with akasavarne dirgaha and you have to form tani plus indoho as tani indoho. So rajan vibhanti bhavatas charitani tani indoho. You are, then what happens is in the meter you will be you will have one matra less or one letter less, one aksharam less. So he takes up that the exception or that rule that you the sa vivaksham apekshate vakyetu sa vivaksham apekshate, it is accordance to the vaktra icha, and so I can make the sandhi or not make the sandhi. If you don't do that, then it shows that you are not able to, you don't have the vocabulary. It'll show that to the audience that the kavi does not have enough vocabulary to make a proper sandhi yukta within the meter chando yukta padyam kartum kavihi na shaknoti iti prayaha patitrunam manasi bhavet. That is why you have to avoid such sandhya bhava. The next is pragrihya hetukam, where there is pragrihya means prakritivad bhava. However the words are, there is no sandhi that happens and it just stays as it is. That is called prakritivad bhava sandhi and it is designated with the samjna pragrihyam. What happens here? Didorbale is in dvivachanam. It ends in a. Let's look at the sutram that he says. Idude dvivachanam pragrihyam. That is the sutram that is applicable here. Eat, oot, et cha dvivachane stito. So the e long vowel, if it is in dvivachanam, not nadi. Nadi is an ekavachanam. Whereas you have vritti, which is vritt, anuvritt, anuvritti, anuvrinti. That is a napunsakalinga ikarantam. Vari varini variini. Something like that, but here the nakaram has not come for this. Kurvat, kurvati, kurvanti. That is for your Napunsakalingam, the Takarantham, where you have the Dvitiya Vibhakti ending in E. U can also happen like Guruhu Guru. Ukarantham, which is Dvivachanam, not Dhenu or Vadhu. That is all Ukarantha, but still it is not Dvivachanam, it is Ekavachanam. So we have to, only if there is Ekarantha, Dirgha Ikara in Dvivachanam, Dirgha Ukara in Dvivachanam, and Eth. Eth ityukte Ekara Dvivachanam. So Palam Phale Phalani. Palam Phale. Napunsakalinga Dvitiya Vibhakti will have Ekarantha. Or Rama Rame Ramaha. That is also Ekarantham. So, Eet, Oot, Eet, Cha, Dvivachanam. Dvivachane, Yat, Eet, Bhavati, Oot, Bhavati, Atava, Eet, Bhavati. Tad, Prakrihya, Samyam. So, there, letter. And that which has the samya of pragrihyam will not occur in any sandhi. You do not combine it with the sandhi. You just take it as that, as such. Dhidorbale atitate. Actually, the sandhi that could have come here is echoayvayavaha, where you could have had bale and the a could have become I, and then balai atitate could have happened. But that will not happen because of this. So pragrihyam samnya, pragrihya samnya, according to Panini's grammar rules, have confined this didorbale atitate to its state, and it has made it impossible for us to make a sandhi there, and a sandhi should not be done according to the rules. That's fine. So it is according to the rules. The first one, there should have been a rule, but he has taken the optionality clause and he has not done a rule so that it will come properly in the meter. That is Aichikaha Sandhya Bhavaha. Atra tu pragrihya samya yuktaha ataha atrapi sandhya bhavaha vidyate. In adi dorbale and then ati tate uchite, there also vritti anuvritti atanvati, also you have the eat there present. So the pragrihya samya comes and then you don't have a sandhi. The third type of sandhya bhava is asiddhi hetukam, which is there in the next shloka. Let me just quickly give the meaning of the next shlokam. Tata udita udara hara hari dyutihi uchaihi udayachalat induhu nijavamsha udatta kanta kantihi bata muktamadivat chakasti anarghaha. The one girl who wants to meet her nayaka or pati, pati. So that pati, the husband, a sakhi is describing that husband to the nayika. So the husband, she says, Induhu iva bhati udeti uditaha. Induhu iva nija vamshe yaha uditaha. Just like how the chandra, moon, has come from the Udayachalat, Uchaihi Udayachalat, from the lofty Udaya mountain, the rising mountain, the Chandra has risen, Uditaha. It has a Udara Hara Hari Dyutihi. Udara Hara, like a great pearl necklace, like a high quality pearl necklace. Haram, Udara Hara, high quality necklace. Hari, which is beautiful. Dyutihi Kantihi, Kanti Yuktaha Induhu Iva. Just like how a moon has the kanti of a very high quality pearl necklace, in the same way your pati is also like that moon. He also has a udara hara hari. Udara hara, just he has a pearl necklace. He's wearing a pearl necklace because she has to say that he is very attractive and you can go with him. So the sakhi is actually prompting the nayika to go and meet her husband. She is a udara hara haridyutihi. He has got a very attractive kanti because he is wearing a beautiful pearl necklace. Saha ayam atra uditaha. Kutra uditaha nija vamshe uditaha. In his family, he is born in his family with an udatta kanta kantihi. He also has a very great kanti, very prakasha kanti, which is udatta, great, and kanta, which is manohara, attractive. How is it attractive? Muktamanivathu. There are two upama he gives here. One is Induriva. The second one is Muktamanivathu, like a pearl necklace. Saha anarghaha, without any mistakes, pure. So anarghaha saha bhati. Nijavamshe saha chakasti. Your pati is actually prakashate kutra swasmin vamshe swasmin kule saha udatta kanti yuktaha prakashate katham uktamanivad prakashate. Here the other meaning for muktamani is also pearls are supposed to come out of great quality bamboo, can give birth to pearls, it seems. I don't know. So nija vamshe tatra vamsha ityasya bamboo can also mean vamsha can also mean kulam. The other thing is bamboo. So just like how from a bamboo a great pearl can come out, in the same way this person has also come from his kulam, which is also great, and he also is great. So not a very great shloka. Sandhi problem here is, again, there is no problem as far as the rules are concerned. It is very much in accordance with Panini's rules, which is tata udita udara. There you have tataha uditaha udara. The visarga has become is not present here. Why? Because sasajushoruhu, the visarga is actually is, so tatas plus udita, so or uditas plus udara, both places there is a sakara. That sakara has become ru by the rule sasajusho ru, and then that ra becomes yakara, bo bago ago apurvasya yuvashi. With that rule it becomes yakara, yakara adeshaha bhavati, yakarasya cha lopashakalyasya iti sutrena yakarasya lopaha bhavati. Tasmad tatra tata udita ityeva bhavati tata udita udara iti. Now here tataha udita, tata udita, you have an a and an u. A guna sandhi can happen with adgunaha, but it cannot happen because adgunaha is purvam. There is a rule in Panini where it says purvatra siddham, purvam shastram prati param asiddham. Purvam shastram ityukte adgunaha comes in sixth sixth adhyaya, shashta adhyaye bhavati, and then whereas lopashakalyasya ashtam adhyaye bhavati, it comes in the eighth adhyaya. If you have applied the a sutra from eighth adhyaya, the rule which appears before, which is in the sixth adhyaya, cannot occur after this. After I have applied lopashakalyasya, I cannot apply adgunaha and say it is tatodito vidahara. I can't say tatodito. It's not possible. Because purvam shastram pati, param shastram, purvatra asiddham, right? So purvam, if we have already applied a later shastra, then the earlier shastra, it becomes inapplicable. That is asiddhi. So adgunaha becomes asiddhi here. Hence, there is no sandhi that can be applied here. So tatodita cannot happen. In the same way, uditodara can also not happen. So the sandhi abhava here is because of asiddhi hetukaha. The same way, nijavamshe udatta is the nijavamshe, the ekara becomes replaced by echo ayavayavaha. Hence you have nijavamshai, nijavamsha ai udatta, and that yakara again is lopashakalyasya. So you have nijavamsha udatta. You cannot again combine it with adgunaha and say nijavamsho udatta. That is asiddhi, and that is called asiddhi hetukaha sandhyabhavaha. So in these two, he has pointed out Vislesha, which is a Sandhya Bhava. I thought I could finish Visandhi today. I don't think I can. So Tata Udita, so the vritti that he gives for both the shlokas is Samhitam na karomi iti svechaya sakridapi doshaha. If someone svechaya, by his own interest, says I will not do a sandhi, samhitam na karomi iti svechaya sakridapi doshaha, even once if you don't do that sandhi, it is a dosham. Pragrihyadi hetuketve प्रगृह्यादिहेतुकत्वे, इफ् इट् इस् प्रगृह्यहेतुकम् आर् असिद्धिहेतुकसन्धि, एण्ड् दट् इस् वै देर् इस् नो सन्धि. इट् इस् वेल् वेल् विदिन् द रूल्स्. ऐ एम् नाट् ट्रान्स्ग्रेसिङ्ग् एनी पाणिनीस् रूल्स्. देर् असकृत् एव दोषः, न तु सकृत्. इफ् वन्स् यु डू लैक् दट् इट् इस् ओके. तत उदित उदार, इन्स्टेड् आफ् द सेकेण्ड् टैम् आल्सो इट् कम्स् रैट्. दट् इस् द प्राब्लम्. If once you do it because of pragrihyam or because of asiddham, then it's okay. If it occurs many times, then there is a bandha visklesham or bandha shaitilyam, where it is, there is no tightness in the meter, and it is that is why the in other words, rasa apakarshakam. So we are not able to enjoy the rasam properly. Okay, I think I have to deal with the next two next class.